Donna?
Oh, it's so good to see you.
Oh, my.
Oh, I'm sorry. Was it all right that I hugged you?
It's fine.
How are you?
I'm doing okay.
We haven't seen you in the office in a while. You missed your annual physical exam last month.
I know. I've been just
so... Dr. Wallace gets persnickety when patients miss their appointment.
Yes, I meant to call, but I just...
I know. Your world has turned upside down. But you can't take care of Ben if you're sick, too.
What?
It's just my two cents. Anyway, we're all praying that Ben can beat this. It's terrible. Terrible. But I think he can. God willing.
Donna!
It's important to keep a positive attitude, you know.
Wait.
What?
Ben and I have been separated for almost a year.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know that. Oh, no.
What's going on?
You didn't know that. Oh, my God. Oh, I'm sorry.
Donna, take a breath. Relax.
I'm going to lose my job.
Just tell me what's going on.
I can't say. I'm sorry.
Oh, yes, you can. I have questions. Hello, Ben.
Hello, Peggy. I assume you're here to see me, not just hanging out.
I'm just here looking at you, trying to stay calm.
About what?
Everything.
Could you be more specific?
Oh, well, let's see. Maybe the fact that you have cancer? When did you find out? Were you diagnosed before or after you left me?
Oh, come on.
Before or after, Ben?
Before. I wasn't trying to hurt you.
Too late for that. Does Carrie know?
No.
Well, I'm glad you're better.
Okay.
You're not a good man.
I know. Peggy, what are you doing? You just can't walk into my house.
The door was unlocked.
You just can't walk in here.
Sorry.
How did you find me?
Donna told me.
Who?
Donna Cheek. Dr. Wallace's nurse.
Damn it. What do you want?
I brought you tomato soup.
No, thank you.
Ben, please. I'm worried about you.
I'm fine.
You have gastric cancer.
Yeah.
You should have told me.
I can take care of myself.
Why are you taking OxyContin?
Because it's fun.
Should you be drinking?
Yes, I should be.
My father died of liver
cancer. No, we're not doing this.
You don't have to listen to me.
I'm not.
Just talk to your oncologist.
Peggy, please leave.
I just have one thing.
Peggy, get the hell out of my house.
No, I'm still your wife. You can give me 5 minutes.
Peggy,
Then if you have any decency left as a human being, just hear me out. You owe me.
All right.
Thank you. I've been racking my brain, trying to figure out why you walked away from our marriage after you were diagnosed with cancer. After. When did you lose faith? You think Carrie got on drugs because of me?
Oh, come on.
You accused me of ignoring Sarah's illness. You think I'm responsible for her death?
I never said that.
You did. It was my job to take care of you and the girls, and I blew it.
This isn't about you.
Yes, it is. Because you'd rather die alone than have someone who loves you take care of you.
Come on, will you just stop it? Will you just chill?
Not if it means losing my husband.
You already lost me, Peggy.
I can take care of you.
I don't want you to take care of me. That's the problem. You've been taking care of me my entire life and I'm fucking miserable.
No.
You can't fix this, Peggy. We're done.
I don't believe that.
God, you are a stubborn old woman.
And you're a stubborn old man.
Well, thank God for that.
Sorry I ruined your life.
I didn't say that.
Yeah, you kind of did. I just need to understand why you left me.
Fine. You want something to drink? I got coffee, bourbon, and water.
A lot of artwork here. Who else lives here?
Just me. It's an Airbnb rental. The owner's in Europe for 2 months.
What are you gonna do after that?
I don't know. I'll figure it out. Don't worry.
You can move in with me.
What?
Nothing.
Here. I can get you something else.
Not here to drink coffee.
Do you remember Valentine's Day 2 years ago?
No.
The pandemic has shut everything down, so we decided to have dinner at home.
Oh, yeah.
That's the day I got the biopsy report.
Why didn't you tell me?
I was planning to.
And?
Why did you move Sarah's urn?
What?
I'm sitting there waiting for you to come home, and I noticed Sarah's urn was on the mantle. You moved it from the bookcase.
So?
So? We decided the bookcase. Remember? We fought about it.
Yes.
And you moved it anyway.
Man, you're not making sense.
You always have to be in control, Peggy. It's the only way you can cope. You moved it because that's what you wanted, not what I wanted. And we always did what you wanted.
That's not true.
Yeah, it is. Because if you didn't get what you wanted, all hell broke loose. So we just let you do what you wanted. You made all the decisions. And I was okay with that. It just didn't work out for the girls, did it? So I'm sitting there and I just kind of snapped. I realized I couldn't do this. I can't allow you to control my life anymore. Because if this is it, if this is how I'm gonna go out, I'm gonna do it on my own terms, not yours.
Ben, you're just scared. You'll get better.
Stop telling me how I feel. I'm not going to get better.
You don't know that.
Yes, I do. I do.
Oh.
Yeah.
I could retire. We could go out west like we talked about for years.
I appreciate the offer, but no. You can leave now.
Isn't there anything I can do for you?
No.
When will you tell Carrie?
Soon.
She'll be devastated. We should do it.
Peggy, I got this.